Hi guys, this is Vijay and I hope you are doing well and you are watching Techno Education Academy. In this video lecture, I am going to talk about working principle of centrifugal pump and its various components. Let us start. There are various applications of centrifugal pump, like as in thermal power station, in mechanical laboratories, in domestic as well as in agriculture application. The special application of centrifugal pump, by using centrifugal pump we can handle any type of slurry. So it is also used in construction line, in corporation, it is also used in drainage system.
The pump which employ centrifugal force for conveying liquids from one place to another place are known as centrifugal pumps. Centrifugal force means the mass is away from centroidal axis. The equation of centrifugal force is Fc equal to m omega square r, where omega is angular velocity equal to 2 pi n upon 60. It means that the centrifugal pump works on the principle of force vortex flow. When a certain mass of liquid is rotated by an external torque, the rise in pressure head of the rotating liquid take place. The rise in pressure head at any point of the rotating liquid is proportional to the square of tangential velocity of the liquid at that point. These pumps are sometimes also called as rotodynamic pumps, as the liquids are handled by rotating impeller within a stationary casing. Now we will discuss the main parts of centrifugal pump, then after I will explain working principle of centrifugal pump. So the first component of centrifugal pump is impeller. The rotating part of centrifugal pump is called impeller. It consists of series of backward curved vanes. The impeller is mounted on shaft, which is connected to the shaft of an electric motor or internal combustion engine. In generally, in agriculture application, the pump is driven by IC engine. The function of the impeller is to convert kinetic energy into pressure energy. How can it convert kinetic energy of liquid into pressure energy? That I will explain to you during explanation of working principle of centrifugal pump. Second component is casing. It is an airtight passage surrounding the impeller and is designed in such a way that the kinetic energy of water discharged at the outlet of impeller is converted into pressure energy before the water leaves the casing and enters the delivery pipe. The following three types of casings are commonly adopted. The first one is a volute type. So is the volute casing. In this type of casing, the impeller surrounded by spiral casing known as volute chamber. It is of spiral type, in which area of flow increases gradually. The increase in area of flow decreases the velocity of flow. The decrease in velocity increases the pressure of water flowing through the casing. We know that in case of a flowing fluid, whenever the cross section area will increase, so pressure will be increases and velocity will be decreases. It has been observed that in case of volute type casing, the efficiency of the pump increases slightly as a large amount of energy lost due to the formation of eddies in this type of casing. Second one, types of casing is vortex casing or whirlpool chamber type. This is an improved type of volute chamber. Here an annular space is provided between the volute and impeller, forming a combination of spiral and circular chamber. The arrangement reduces eddies to a considerable amount and improves the performance of the pump. Third one type of casing is casing with guide vanes or diffuser type. Here impeller is surrounded by series of guide blades mounted on a ring, which is known as diffuser. The guide blades are designed in such a way that the water from the impeller enters the guide vanes without shock. Also, the area of the guide vanes is increased, thus reducing the velocity of flow through guide vanes and consequently increases the pressure of water. This pump gives a more pressure head as compared to vortex types and volute types construction. The diffuser type of pump has a therefore higher efficiency. These pumps are also called turbine pumps. Third part of centrifugal pump is suction pipe with foot wall and strainer. A pipe whose one end is connected with the inlet of the pump and other end dips into water in a sump is known as suction pipe. The foot wall opens only in upward direction. A strainer is also fitted at the lower end of the suction pipe to remove the impurities during suction. Fourth part of centrifugal pump is a delivery pipe. A pipe whose one end is connected to the outlet of the pump and other end delivers the water as a required height is known as delivery pipe. Now I will explain working principle of centrifugal pump. The pump is driven by power from an external source like as motor or engine by which impeller rotated. When the impeller rotates inside the casing, the liquid is discharged from its center by the action of centrifugal force and vacuum is generated at the suction eye which is connected with the suction pipe through which the liquid from sump rushes to impeller due to negative pressure or vacuum in suction eye. It will work on a centrifugal force, and centrifugal force means the mass is away from centroidal axis. So in impeller eye, vacuum will be generated because mass is thrown away from its center. These liquid particles have large acceleration and it is decelerated after striking with curved blades of impeller. As we know that according to first law of thermodynamics, we cannot generate the energy and we cannot destroy the energy, but whatever the energy available in nature, they all are convertible with each other. So here in impeller, the kinetic energy of liquid is converted into pressure energy. Thus at the outlet of impeller where radius is more, the rise in pressure head is more and the liquid will be discharged at outlet with a high pressure head.